So in this season, some of y'all are being called to rest because of your calling. And many of y'all are trying to fight and run from your calling. But God said, time is up, okay? Y'all know how I be playing around and I be telling y'all to take a nap in many of my videos. I be like, take a nap when I get frustrated with y'all. I be joking and playing around. But I be really serious about y'all taking a nap because I know how important naps are. Especially at 36. I know how important naps are, and I also know how important it is to rest when you are tired. I also know how important it is to rest when you have a calling on your life, because you need the energy to preach to people, to minister to people, to teach people, to spread God's gospel, to teach people repentance, to teach people about their salvation and their delivery. You need energy for all of those things. So I know how important it is to rest. So I be playing with y'all and I'm like, take a nap. But I really be meaning that, because some of y'all really be needing to take a nap. And I'm going to tell you again today, if you ain't take one, go take you a nap. Go take a nap and see how much better you feel today. Okay? Some of y'all are worn out, drained, irritated, angry. And but I guarantee if you got some rest and properly, and actually worked on nourishing your body with some good food, some good fruits and some good veggies, something that's actually really good for the soul, good for the body, your energy will come back to you. You'll feel replenished. You'll feel, you know, like you could do 52 backflips after you got some rest and you put something good into your body to fuel not only your soul and your energy, but just to fuel you overall, right? So some of y'all really need to get into that, okay? And as I was thinking about resting and calls and callings and being chosen and all of that good stuff, I started thinking about the prophet Elijah, and I just started cracking up because... If you look, read Elijah's story, man, you can look at that. I think that's in 1 Kings. If you look, read about Elijah's story, you know, he fled from Ahab and Jezebel because, you know, he was afraid because she had put out a hit on his life pretty much, because he was trying to get him and Ahab and old girl, Lord, that Jezebel jail. He was trying to get her to serve God in spirit and in truth and to stop worshiping the statues and stop worshiping Baal and to serve God wholeheartedly. And they didn't want to hear that. So he ran. He ran from them. He fled with his servant. He dropped his servant off in the city. What city was that? Was that Bathsheba? What city was that? I forgot what city it was. And then he went into the wilderness. And as he walks into the wilderness, your man goes to sleep. He goes to sleep and he gets some rest. Not only does he get some rest, because if the angels hadn't woken up that man, he probably would have still been sleeping, because that's how tired he was. Can you imagine? Remember, they were on foot back in the day. They wanted to leave. They were walking everywhere, just walking. Chill. But if the angel hadn't woke him up, the angel woke him up twice to give him cake and something to drink. And whatever was in that cake was good, because it sustained that man for 40 days and for 40 nights. And he was able to walk towards his calling and to go preach and to spread the good news and to spread God's gospel and to spread he spoke a lot about repentance and stuff like that, and salvation and deliverance. He spread all of that, right? And what the angel gave him was enough to sustain that, to sustain him for 40 days and for 40 nights, okay? And I say all that to say this: some of y'all have really been out here for 40 days and for 40 nights, but y'all don't have that angel cake or that drink that the angel gave Elijah. Y'all have been out here running on E, pretty much. Y'all are not properly rested. Y'all are not properly nourished. But y'all have been going and going and going and going and going. Going and going and going. And y'all have not been resting, okay? And not only have many of y'all have been going, but y'all have been going and doing your own things. And y'all have been running from the call. That cake and that drink that the angel offered Elijah, God wants to offer that to many of you all. But because y'all are running and trying to do your own thing, he can't give it to you. Can't get it to you because y'all ignoring it and ignoring him. But guess what? God is still God. Y'all got your own little free will and all of that, but God is still very much in control. And when he's called you to do something, he's going to call you to do it and make you do it. But some of y'all are really out here like that, exhausted, and you need to take a nap. Some of y'all are working all of these hours. Y'all not listening to what God really wants y'all to do. Some of y'all, and I know some of y'all don't want to hear this, but some of y'all are not even really supposed to have 9-to-5. So y'all are supposed to be having your own businesses or focusing full-time on your ministries. this message is not for everybody. Let me put that out there, because some of y'all have really good 9-to-5s where your ministries are attached to your 9-to-5s. Okay, just don't be up and going, oh, I gotta quit my job. I got to quit my... No. You stay in your 9-to-5. God is telling you to stay there and minister and whatever he's called you to do. You do that. But for many of you, your calling is not in that 9-to-5 that you're currently at. Your calling is your calling, and it's most likely to minister to people and to spread the gospel. And another thing I want to point out, everywhere Elijah went, God had someone there to provide for him, right? He sent someone to help him everywhere he went. So everywhere you go, once you get your instructions from God, I don't know if God has been telling you how to leave your jobs, God has been telling you to work on a business, or you've just been tired and whatever it is, get clear instructions from God first, of course, first and foremost. But wherever you go, God is going to provide. I kid you no lie, y'all. He will send you somebody to help you wherever you go. But make sure y'all are rested, because in this season where God has taken many of his sons and his daughters, it requires rest. Ministering to people requires rest. You need a lot of spiritual and physical and mental rest when you are called to minister, when you are called to teach, when you are called to preach, when you are called to spread the good news and the gospel. You need a lot of rest, all right? Again, take a nap. Get you some rest. Nourish your bodies properly, right? Fill yourselves up with some good stuff. And you take this message back to God in prayer. It's going to serve as confirmation for someone, because someone has probably been thinking about their job and thinking about what God is calling them to do. And then some of y'all have been thinking about how y'all been running from the call as well. Stop running, because I'm telling you, I don't know why y'all think you can run for God. Run from God, because God is up there laughing at y'all, the ones that are running from your calling, because he's going to get you into your calling, whether you like it or not, okay? So this message is not for everybody. I always tell you, I take every message that you come across, including mine, take it back to God in prayer. But for the love of God, go take a nap and get you some rest.